And then after that, I decided to get a If this video isn't a clear representation of how my life has been for the past 2 months, then I don't know what is. It's been quiet, a lot of peace, a lot of silence, you know, tranquility and all that, but also a lot of emotions, a lot of confusion, and a lot of sadness. This is probably going to be the last video I post before the year ends, so I just want to share my little bit about this year. I feel like 2023 was a very confusing year for me and also for most people. I cried a lot this year, you know, I had a lot of breakdowns, I learned a lot about myself, I had a lot of self-realization, and this was also the year where I actually got to open myself to God, you know, and actually get to build a relationship, not build a relationship, but to get to know God on a personal level. And this is the year where I got to lose a lot of things and I got to gain a lot of things as well.
Okay, so I just finished doing my hair. I just need to do a little lip liner, you know, to look cute and whatever, and probably spray more water on this hair. But now I'm gonna get dressed. I know that I need to look professional, but I don't know what to wear, so I'm gonna go with this. I think this is literally the only formal pants I have. Nah, I have a green one, but these are the only ones that still fit me, you know. So yeah. Okay, so this is what the pants is giving. It makes me look so skinny. I know I'm not thick like that, but I don't think I'm this small. Anyways, next we are going to wear this, my dad's shirt. I've had this shirt for I don't know how long. Like, this is my dad's shirt because I don't own any shirt, and I promise that the shirt is ironed. It's just that the material of the shirt, I don't know, where did he even buy it from? Not like you're actually gonna help me, but what do you think? Do you think it would look better if I left it like this, right, with the pants? You guys can't see the full outfit, but it's really cute. And then just wear my heels, because I have these heels that I want to wear. Or I should tuck it in and then put on like a half jersey, because that was the initial idea that I had. But I don't know, man. I feel like this, it looks really cute. This is the other option. In my opinion, this actually looks a bit more professional, but I want to top it up with this half what. I had to change my whole outfit, well, the pants only, and I had to wear the green ones that are tight. Like, I can barely breathe in these, but I don't have a choice because these are the only two formal pants that I have that I can actually wear. You know, they didn't give me enough time to prepare for this interview, even though I would have bought something to wear, and I didn't have money. Times are hard, it's not month end. Yeah, so this is the new outfit. Wish me luck. Bye.
Funny story about this interview, y'all. It actually ended up being a scam because they didn't call me. I tried calling them again, but it didn't go through. But anyways, let's continue with the video.
Hi guys, I just got back. If tired was a person, it would be me right now. I just got back from the interview, and yeah, I got the job. So the company is gonna call me by next week, Wednesday, so I can start working. I just want to eat and sleep. I'm tired.
So on this day, I was feeling a little sad, I think I was almost getting depressed. I'm not gonna lie. I don't know what depression feels like, but I feel like I was getting to that point. But yeah, so I decided, why not cast all my burdens onto Jesus? So I decided to set up a date with Jesus and invite him, you know, and just spend some time with him and talk about all my problems. And this is a habit that I'm trying to cultivate for the new year 2024. So every month, maybe the beginning of the month, I think the beginning, which because I feel like it's going to give me a clearer direction on how to go towards the end of the month. I didn't do it this December though, because this video is from last month. Would you believe that? I'm so lazy when it comes to editing. Oh my gosh. But yeah, so I just got myself into the presence of God, invited the Holy Spirit, and of course my favorite part is praise and worship. Even on Sundays, I never want to miss praise and worship. And like I was saying earlier, this year has been a very, very, very difficult year for me, because I felt like this year God kept me in isolation. He removed me from certain places, certain environments. And at first I didn't understand it, because I used to cry a lot. I'm like, God, why would you do this? Why would you take me out of this place? Why would you separate me from fun? Like, I could fun. The things that I thought were fun, God made me understand that these things are not good for me if I really want to be called his child. If I want to have an identity in him, I need to restrict myself from certain things. I need to separate myself from certain environments. So yeah, so I decided to spend more time with my family, spend more time with myself, spend more time with God. Certain things I don't do anymore. I'm still human. I still make mistakes. I still fall sometimes. But I am, the difference between me now and the old me is that whenever I fall, I realize it as quick as possible, because I get convicted by the Holy Spirit and I bounce back on my feet and I ask for forgiveness and I work towards the right path, towards the path of righteousness. The difference between the me now and the me then is that now I'm living for God, and back then I was living for the world and myself. I didn't really care much. But yeah. So on this day, I got invited by one of my friends to their church conference. And then after that, we decided to get dinner. It was delicious. I'm not going to lie. This food was bussing. Then after that, we just started talking about like random things, about like the things that had passed. And you don't want to know what we're talking about. Trust me. And then, yeah, after that, we also talked about Christ. Like, guys, I love having, you know, Christian friends. Like, this thing of wanting to live for Christ, you know, this new habit, like this new found reality, it's not easy. I'm not gonna lie, you can't do it alone. You need people that are always gonna keep you on your toes, and I'm glad that I have a few of those people around me. And I am still searching for more, but the thing is, I'm very picky when it comes to people though, because it's like, are you the right person for me? I'm very picky when it comes to people, because I can be friendly, but also I can be, people say I can be a little mean. Not mean like that, but like, I don't like people. I don't know, man. I could just, but I'm praying for it. Like, I'm really praying against it, against the habit of not liking people, in quotes. I don't know how to call it. I don't know how else to put it. But yeah, so I'm really praying against that. So yeah, let's hope that 2024 will be a better year. But yeah, for now, I think that's enough of my voice.
It's not just them that's doing it. It's God that's using them through the things that they have. You understand? So I talk to anyone. I don't care. Social media, face to face, I can talk to anyone. But there are some people that can't do that face to face.
The view is crazy. It's crazy, fam.